about next season?
Yeah, sure, talk away.
It was something you said at the start of the season earlier. It really stuck with me. It's
something good, I hope.
Well, it was something you said about treat your men like your beloved sons and they'll follow you into the deepest valley. And that really got me. It got me thinking about the way I treat you boys, and I wasn't being fair to you and Tommy, for that matter, or the team.
Wow, Coach, I really appreciate that.
All that being said, I wanted to go into the offseason with everyone on the same page. I figured the best way that we could do that would be to announce a starter. Tommy's gonna be our starter.
But how could you possibly make that decision after the title game? Is Tommy even going to be able to play?
Yeah, I spoke with his doctor. Valve replacement surgery was great. He's going to be right as rain.
I just don't understand.
I know this is hard for you. It's hard for you to process, and I hope you believe me when I say that I take no joy in making this decision. But I stand firmly behind it because, frankly, Tommy's a better fit for the offense.
Well, what does this mean for me?
Well, it means that you are at a monumental crossroads in your life, and you've got two choices. You can enter the draft, and based on what you did last year, I'd say you'd be lucky to get picked in the third round. But realistically, you're looking at a late round selection, if at all.
Jeez, don't sugarcoat it for me.
Well, I'm trying to be open and honest with you. From this moment forward, I'm giving it to you as I would my own beloved son.
And my other choice?
Well, the way I see it, you got too much raw athleticism to waste sitting on the bench. Your talent is a true gift. And it's one that I'm going to give you the opportunity to show it to the world.
And how's that?
You get to pick a new position on offense and get your heartbreak kids thing going back again.
Heartbreak kids. Well, Tommy's already tried recruiting me to come back so we can win the title together.
Does that mean you're in?
Plus, he did switch positions once, and you see how well that worked out for him. I guess I can try it too.
The heartbreak kids are back, baby.
I don't regret it for a second. Of course, everyone's first thought was, where am I going to play? It felt good, telling everyone I was sticking around and Tommy and I were gonna play together. The next question was, did it actually work out?
Pretty drastic turn of events for Coach O'Brien's program. I mean, the defensive pantry has been pretty much left dry with most of that elite unit having bolted for the NFL. But today, Coach O'Brien revealed a new strategy, and I think it's kind of brilliant. Get both heartbreak kids on the field at the same time. I mean, it's really a brilliant move. Here's the deal. You got to get all of your talented players on the field at once, certainly if they're going to rely on the offense for a change to be the strength of this team if they're planning on making another run at it.
Me and Kurt feel the same. Too much pleasure is pain. My girl spites me in vain. All I do is complain. She needs something to change. Need to take off the ass. So fuck it all tonight. And don't tell me to shut up when you know you talk too much. But you don't got shit to say. I want you out of my head. I want you out of my bedroom tonight. There's no way I can save you, 'cause I need to be saved too. I'm no good at goodbyes. We're both acting insane, but too stubborn to change. Now I'm drinking again, 80 proof in my veins, and my fingers stained. Looking over the ass, don't fuck with me tonight. Say you needed this heart, then you got it. Turns out that it wasn't what you wanted, and we wouldn't let go when we lost it. Now I'm a goner. I want you out of my head. I want you out of my bedroom tonight. There's no way I can save you, 'cause I need to be saved too. I'm no good at goodbyes.
I want you out of my life. I want you back here tonight. I'm trying to cut you, no knife. I wanna slice you and dice you.
My argument possessive, it got you precise. Can you not turn off the TV? I'm watching it fight. Athletic garage, blue diamond on shock. You're popping like dog, he's Nicki Minaj. You don't need a key to drive, your car on a charger. I just wanna see the side, the one that's unbothered.
Good at goodbyes.
Performance, weapons galore on the offensive side of the football, and they finish things off in style as they will be crowned the champions of the college football world.
Hey, you know, it was really great what you did.
What do you mean?
I know you could have gone to the draft last year, but instead you risked everything to come back here and help us. It means a lot to me, man.
Hey, we've been through it all together, man. You know I love you like a brother. So, are you feeling thankful enough to finally admit that I'm Batman?
Come on, let's not get carried away now. But hey, I will admit, you're no Robin.
Okay.
Well, at least there's that.
Superman.
Supes.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, I can work with that.
Yeah, you know, he's Batman's equal, his biggest rival. And even though they battle it out from time to time, they always wind up back as close friends.
I can definitely work with that.
But hey, just in case you ever go stepping out of line, you should know that I always keep an extra thing of kryptonite on me at all times.
You might need that in the NFL against me. No cap.